Hi there folks, in today's demonstration we're going to have a look at how to build out a Power Automate flow that will detect duplicates in a data source. So whether that's a Dataverse table or a SharePoint list or maybe some data from SQL or a third-party API, ultimately we're working with arrays, we're going to use select, we're going to repurpose some data, and we're going to be able to identify and detect any duplicates based on specific columns in that data source. Once we've detected those duplicates, we'll be able to keep the first example and delete any subsequent duplicates. Now, if that's something that interests you, don't forget to like and subscribe. And without further ado, let's jump into the demonstration. So I'm going to kick things off from Excel, and I have a data source here where we have an ID column, which represents the ID of the item or the row or that particular record within your data set that you've retrieved from an API. And then I've got a couple of columns, the owner and the description, and it's based on these two columns that I'd like to try and detect duplicate rows. I've finally got a date time at the end, which is relevant to me in that I want to delete or keep the most recent record or one of many records. And so I'm going to explain via expressions in Excel how we can implement that in Power Automate using some conditional expressions within a select action. So first up, if I was to order the owner that we've got here, we can see now that Alex Wilbur actually has three duplicates for the right documentation for the API. If I look at Henrietta Muller, we can see that she has two duplicates for the configure and deploy the application. And those two examples there have different times, so 1509 and 1505. And of course, I might want to get rid of the 1505 and keep the most recent 1509. In order to make this data now more useful, if we use the sort functionality and do a custom sort, I can add in both the description and also the date time, albeit with the date time, I'm going to sort in descending order. And if we go ahead and hit OK, we can see now that when we look at Alex Wilbur and that particular write documentation for the API, that we have the most recent record for each of those examples at the top. And again, if we look at Henrietta Muella, you can see again that the 1509 time is at the top there for the configure and deploy. So ultimately, I'd like to be able to keep that record and delete the one beneath. So in order for me to detect this, what I would do is I would use a concatenation. So if I go ahead and type in concat, I can join both the owner and the description and create a new string. And you can see now I have this string based on Alex Wilbur and his description. If I copy that down, again, I've extended that to now include all of those individual owners and descriptions. As an expression, what I'd like to do now is detect whether or not the row above equals the row below. And if it does, then I know I have a duplicate. So here, F2 does not equal F1. F3 does not equal F2. F4 does equal F3. And so at that point, we know that we have a duplicate. And so we would aim to delete this one and ultimately this one. In terms of formulas, all we need to do is type in if, and then if F2 equals F1, then it's a true, as in we want to delete it. Otherwise, it is a false, as in we don't want to delete it. And if I copy that formula down my screen right now, we can see that the T's highlight any duplicates that we'd want to remove from our data source. Next up, I'd like to introduce you to my very large list, which is what I'm going to use for my demonstration within Power Automate. I have over 5,000 items. I know there are a significant number of duplicates based on the task description and task owner columns. And I have a couple of other columns that I'll be ignoring for this duplicate detection, as the focus is these two particular columns. I also have a created date, which I'm going to use to sort the data so that I can keep the most recent records for all of the duplicates that have been detected. This is very much like the data source that I've just demonstrated in Excel. Next up, we're in Power Automate where I have a manual trigger and I'm getting those items from my large list. And it's worth just remembering from that Excel demo that I did, I'm also ordering the data. So if you can order the data from your data source, fantastic. Today, in this demonstration, I'm going to assume that I can't, even though technically I could, just to demonstrate how it would be done. So first up, get items, then I'm going to use a select action. And with that select action, I'm going to repurpose the data from my data source, and I need to specify the columns that I'm looking to detect duplicates on. So in this case, it was the owner and also the description of the task, if you remember. And then I had the created date time, which I'll add in there. And then finally, the ID. So how am I going to delete these duplicates? It's all going to be based on an ID. The final part is a concatenation. So I would like to concat both the owner and the description to create a new column within my data source. And then because I'm also doing a sort by created date time, I'm actually going to do a second concatenation, and I'm going to call that sort by, and we'll use that later on in this solution. So when it comes to the owner, I'm going to pick out the dynamic values for owner, in this case, not the task owner, but the task owner display name. Then when it comes to the description and everything else, I'll go ahead and pick out those values. We'll grab created, and I'll also grab ID too. Right, with the concatenation, it's all based on an expression, and you can type in concat. Then you can jump back across to dynamic content, and you'll note that actually, for my situation anyway, I'm not seeing those dynamic values. So this is when you need to know a bit about expressions. And if I hover my mouse, I can see the expression there for the task owner display name. So I can simply type in task owner and display name in the single quotes. So we'll type task owner / display name, and I want to concat that with the task description. So I put in a comma, and then I can type in my second expression. So in with my single quotes again, and in with task description. So you would do exactly the same based on your column names. Now at this point, if I had a third, of course I could put in a comma, put in the third. But for this particular concatenation, because I'm comparing the owner and the description, I just want these two column names. I am, however, going to copy this expression, Control A, Control C, hit OK, and then if I jump back into sort by, I can Control V to paste back in, and I'm going to add in the third value, which is for my created date time. So I can type in item, open close brackets, square brackets and singles, and that is created. So that now gives me a second concatenation with the created date, which is just going to allow me to sort the data based on those three columns in that order. So next up, I want to sort that data, and I'm going to use that second concatenation I did. So I'll go into my compose. Remember, it's important that these rows run in order. And if I go into the expression tab, I can type in sort with the open close brackets into my dynamic content, choose my select, and then all I need to do is specify the name of that column to sort by, which in my case, I called sort by. If I hit OK, just to remind ourselves, if I pop open that select, it's based on this value here, which is my concatenation. So I'm sorting the select above based on the key sort by. That'll now give me all those rows in a nice sequential order, A to Z, and in the order of the owner description, created date, time. Next, it's all about detecting those duplicates. And we saw again that in the Excel demo, where I compared the row above with the row below to see if they matched. If they did, we output a T. If they didn't, I output an F. And what we're gonna do here, instead of using one of the arrays as an input, we're going to use range. And so range allows you to select a number to start with, and then how many numbers. So a length in this case. So I'm going to use the expression length, which is based on the length of the array. So if we had 10 items, we'd have an array that runs from 0 all the way through to 9. And it just so happens that we can use these numbers as integer index values to select each of the objects in our array, or all the items, or all the rows within our data source. And this is the clever bit that will allow us to compare row 0 against row 1, or row 2 against row 3, using another expression, subtract, where we literally take away 1 from the number that's generated by this range expression. Jumping over to the map, we're now going to turn this into text mode and then jump into the expression editor, and we can use the add property expression, and it allows us to add a new property into an object. So the object we're looking to add a property to is all based on, if I go into the dynamic content, our compose, our sorted array. And like I say, we can use the integer indexes, so question mark, square brackets, rather than having a fixed name, we're using a number, and that number just happens to be item with the open and close brackets. So that'll be the 0, the 1, the 2, the 3, etc., based on that range. When it comes to adding in the key name, we have to think about what we want that key to be called. I'm going to call it isDuplicate. So we'll have a new key or column within this array to indicate, is that a duplicate or not? And then the final piece is an expression. So if the row above equals the row below, output a T, otherwise output an F. And that will be based on if the open close brackets equals with the open close brackets, and then the two values that we want to compare. So we'll first of all want to compare the output from the compose, and I'll just move my cursor to the end here of the output of the compose, so the first closing bracket there, and it's based on that item, so that number that we're getting as part of that range, and then we want to get the concat value, so we want to get that concatenated string to compare it against the row above. And the way we do that, a comma, and we put in exactly the same expression again with a subtle change. So again, the output of that compose, I'll go to the end of that first bracket, I'll put in a question mark with our item open close brackets, again the end of that square bracket, another question mark with the word concat, which will get our concatenated string. We're currently comparing ourselves against ourselves, but with this item, which is our number, our 0, 1, 2, 3, we simply want to subtract 1 from it. So we'll insert sub, go to the end of that closing bracket, put in a comma, put in a 1, put in a closing bracket, and we're now comparing one row against the other row. Moving along this expression, if we go to the first closing bracket at the end of this equals, we're now into the if again. I can put in a comma, and I can put in a T for true, another comma, and an F for false. And now we know that any that match will output a T, and any that don't match will output an F, exactly the same as we had in that Excel demo. I'll hit OK, everything's been accepted, and now all I need to do is to filter this array for any that equal to true or any that equal to false. And we'll go ahead and insert this filter array action. So the filter array is going to be based on the output from the select two, and all we're going to be doing is looking at this property is duplicate, so this new property that we've added. So in this choose a value, we can go into expression, we can type in the infamous item, open close brackets and single quotes, and type in is duplicate. And with that, we can then see, is it equal to a T? Because if it is, we know it's one we're gonna delete, and so we can rename that to delete me. And if I go ahead and copy that, and we can paste that into our browser, into our clipboard, I can call this one keep me, and we can change the condition so that it instead filters based on the F for false. So I'll pop that open and I'll change that to an F. So that's the delete me, that's the keep me, based on the filter, is the duplicate equal to the true or the false? And just last of all, as a wee check, I'm going to add in a compose here, and we can get some counts. So number of rows, we'll go number to delete, and then number to keep. And of course, the number of rows should equal the number to delete plus the number to keep. The number of rows is based on the length expression, and we can go into dynamic content and get the length of our original sorted array here. The number to delete is again based on the length, and it will be based on that output from the delete me filter. Number to keep, if you haven't guessed, I go and do the length again into the dynamic content, keep me, hit OK. And when it comes to actually physically deleting the items, if I was to add and apply to each, I won't go ahead and actually clear out my list because I need it for another demo. But if I insert our delete me array, so as the input here, the delete me, I can add an action, we'll just go ahead with a compose, and we can output the IDs of the items that we're looking to delete. So the ID is just going to be based on the expression item, open close brackets, square brackets, single quotes, and ID. Now, having put the flow through test mode, if I have a look at the outcome, you can see we have run the get items in 3 seconds, and then the rest of the actions have taken, again, a handful of seconds to do this comparison and crunching with the arrays and the columns, etc. The apply to each took a bit longer. It was a loop. It did go through 4,391 records from the 5,000 that apparently should have been deleted, but you can see the ID being output, and of course you would pass that ID into your delete action for whatever data source that was. If we start from the select at the beginning, if you remember, we took the input from the get items, and then with the outputs, we were selecting specific rows or specific keys and values. So the owner, the description, the created time, and the ID. And then we did a concatenation, both with the owner and description, and then for the sort by that included that date and time. If we have a look at the compose, it was then based on a sort. So this is now sorted by that concatenation. And at the beginning of my data, I have a lot of null values, it just so happens. But as I scroll down a bit further, you can start to see some examples there of how things have started to order based on that owner description and created time being appended in that concatenation and in a specific order. And then if we look at this select two, you can see that range has gone from 0 all the way to the length of that array, and there happened to be 5,000, so it stops at 4,999. And then it's using that we've been able to create this next array that includes this property is duplicate, and it's set to either false or true depending on whether or not the row above matches the row below. So the first one is false because there's nothing above it, and then the one after that and so on is equal to true. And if we scroll down a bit further and get one with a bit of text, let's have a look at this one here. You can see we've started off with an F. This is the first instance of Alistair analyzing website traffic. It's in a specific date time order. So we have actually the oldest one here. Had we looked to keep the newest, we might have used the reverse expression rather than the sort expression. And then we would have kept the newer record. But ultimately we can see that there is duplicate for this first one here is set to false. And then everyone after that is equal to true. And as we scroll down again, we have the next example where there's a collaborate with the design team. Again, we have one set to false, and then all of them after that set to true, and so on. The final bit is looking at the delete me. Again, if I pop that open, that's going to have all the ones that were set to true. And of course, the keep me is all the ones that are set to false. And if I pop open that compose too, where we have our summary, there are 5,000 rows. 4,391 to be deleted, which matches our apply to each loop, and then 609 to keep. And so that marks the end of the demonstration. Lots to learn there. We've seen a use of select again with repurposing data, the add property, so you can add new key values. We've got concat, so we can bring together some strings, and we're also sorting our arrays using the sort or the reverse expression. So if that's something you enjoyed, please make sure you like and subscribe, and I hope to see you again sometime soon. Thanks for watching.